one thing about rivers, they rarely stay the same for long. Low and clear one day, high and muddy the next. Each time on a river is a new experience, a new investigation in tracking down cat locations.
You gotta have a little bit of a drag set here. Make sure it's set properly.
It's about time.
Yeah, I think so.
I know, they've really been beating you up. Finally got the timing down on the hook set, and it's really, seems like you pulled up. The other thing, I think it's also just getting where the bigger fish are at, you know what I mean? We started at the head of this hole, moved into a number of different anchor positions, and fan casting, and it seems like this is the core of the hole, the best cover here. Granted, the biggest cats in this particular section of the river.
Kind of handsome, isn't he?
Yeah.
When you look at him. They're a sensory organ and have no trouble finding bait, even in these dark water conditions. And being a clear water angler for smallmouth and walleyes, you get into a river situation like this and you go, wow, how are the fish ever going to find the bait? But cats, no problem. In fact, they like it. Sometimes the darker, the better, and they can be very shallow. This particular river, we're finding them in, I don't know, there's 4 to 5 feet of water up against those log jams and probably the main river channel, what, Jim, 6, 7, 8 feet maybe, some holes in here?
That's the deepest water.
The deepest
Yeah, 6 to 8 foot. The majority of the river's only like 3 to 4 foot deep right now. So holes are sort of relative, you know, depends on the given river you happen to be on. You know, you get in a real small river, 3 to 4 foot hole might be a hole, while the flats and the runs are only 2 foot, a foot and a half.
And you get on a big river like the Mississippi or Missouri or several of those other big southern rivers, and you have 25, 30 feet of water and more would be a hole.
Yeah.
So it's all relative compared to the body of water you're on. And it takes a little poking around to find the prime spots, but when you do, they'll produce, you know, sometimes all season long, depending on the water levels and the current flows, like Jim pointed out. You just need to anchor up and get your baits in the right position.
It's really unbelievable. That's a little bit better one. There we go. Come here, buddy.
There you go, Jim.
There you go. Now that's what we're talking about. That's a pretty nice one for a small river cat. That's about classic catfishing in small rivers all across North America. Look at that beautiful fish. They're tough. I can tell you one thing. And the way we're fishing them, with medium to heavy action bass gear. And that's perfect for hooking and landing them. You'll see where we're catching some small ones, but you're hooking some of those bigger ones when they get that size in a little bit, maybe it's up to about 12 pounds. You're gonna need this type of equipment to pull them out of there.